pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper, and he took off his outer garment. He took a towel and he tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet, to dry them with a towel. He came to Simon Peter and said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "Lord, you will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and my head as well." But Jesus had his last supper in this room as well. And the reason, obviously, the disciples came here on Pentecost was because it was familiar. But for a moment, just pray that God's Spirit would reveal to us what's taking place in this room, that Jesus instituted the Eucharist here, that Jesus instituted the priesthood here, that Jesus washed the feet of the disciples here, that the Holy Spirit came upon the disciples and the women here. I can't think of any places that are more sacred for us. Jesus, we come to a place that we want to say thank you. It just seems like thank you isn't enough, and we are so grateful here in this place for the Eucharist, because in the Eucharist that is a perfect thanksgiving. It's a thanksgiving that we enter into between the Father and the Son. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. As I was praying, I just had this image of us leaving here, and that's why I read the washing of the feet, was because happened here, we're supposed to take out, and we're supposed to be able to wash other people's feet as well as Jesus washed their feet. Lord, you call us to something more, and you call us to something new. Breathe on us in this place. Breathe your Spirit, greater reverence for adoration. Come with your Spirit that animates our heart. The same Spirit that transforms bread and wine transforms us. The same Spirit that changes a man to a priest.